Hi everyone, I'm Sonia Gio, a faculty of Silver Hills Public School. Here I'm going to discuss about the chapter Light, Reflection and Refraction of Class 10 CBSE. For your better understanding, I have divided this chapter into different topics. The various colors of the rainbow, the tingling effect of stars, etc. are based on different properties of light. Optics, the branch of physics which deals with the study of light, which helps us to study more about it. All of us are familiar with the light. At night, when we switch on a bulb, everything in the room becomes visible. Nothing is seen when the bulb is off. Do you know how can we see the images? Yes, it's because of reflection of light. The main source of light is sun. An object reflects light that falls on it. This reflected light, when received by our eyes, enables us to see things. Today's section, I'm going to discuss about the topic reflection of light. The phenomenon of bouncing back of light is called reflection of light. A highly polished surface reflects most of the light falling on it due to its smooth surface. Reflection are of two types, regular reflection and diffuse reflection. In regular reflection, all the reflected rays are parallel to each other. But in case of diffuse reflection, all the reflected rays are not parallel to each other. And in regular reflection, the reflection takes place on a smooth polished surface, and in diffuse reflection, that reflection takes place on a rough surface. Consider this figure. A ray of light incident on the mirror, and that light reflects back or bouncing back. Consider, let AB be the incident ray, BC be the reflected ray, then draw normal, BN be the normal. So we can say that incident ray means the ray that falls on the object or plane at the point of incidence. Reflected ray means the ray bouncing back after reflection from the point of incidence. Normal, an imaginary line that divides the angle between the incident ray and the reflected ray into two equal angles. Let's study about the laws of reflection. There are two laws of reflection. The first law is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. See, angle of incidence means angle between incident ray and the normal. Angle of incidence is the angle between incident ray and the normal. Then angle of reflection means angle between normal and reflected ray. So the first rule is angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Then the second rule is incident ray, normal and reflected ray all lie in the same plane. I repeat, incident ray, normal and reflected ray all lie in the same plane. So we can say that the ray AB, the ray BC and the ray BN all lie in the same plane. The Greek mathematician Euclid came up with the laws of reflection. Next topic is spherical mirrors. There are two types of spherical mirrors, concave mirror and convex mirror. Spherical mirrors means the mirrors which are the part of a sphere. The mirrors which are the part of a sphere are called spherical mirrors. Consider this figure. With the help of this steel spoon, we can explain the surface of the convex and concave mirror. If you are considering a steel spoon, the inner surface of the spoon serves as a concave mirror. And the outer surface of the spoon serves as a convex mirror. So this is concave mirror. Concave mirror means if the reflective surface of the spherical mirror is curved inwards, it is called a concave mirror. Concave mirrors forms real and virtual images. Real image is always inverted image. Virtual image is always erect image. Then real image means we can focus that image to a screen. Real image, we can focus that image to a screen. But for the case of a virtual image, image cannot be obtained on a screen. For example, if we are looking our face on the plane mirror, we can see our image, right? We cannot focus that image to a screen. So such images are called virtual images. So this concave mirror forms real images and virtual images. Convex mirror. If the reflective surface of the spherical mirror is curved outwards, it is called a convex mirror. The image produced by a convex mirror is always virtual and erect, and it is always located behind the mirror. Representation of concave and convex mirror. This is the way we can represent concave and convex mirror. First one is concave mirror and second one is convex mirror. This is the reflecting surface of the concave mirror, and second one which represents the reflecting surface of the convex mirror. Next topic, terms related to mirrors. There are different terms like center of curvature, radius of curvature, pole, etc. We can study one by one. First one, pole. Look at the picture. First one is concave mirror and second mirror is convex mirror. In concave mirror, consider the reflective surface of the mirror. Pole means it is the center of the reflecting surface of a mirror. You can see the point P. The letter P is used for pole. Then the pole is, it is the center of the reflecting surface of a mirror. For the case of a convex mirror, same way, it is the center of the reflecting surface of a mirror. The pole is represented by the letter P. Then second one, principal axis. Principal axis is the straight line passing through the center of curvature C and pole. Same definition for convex mirror also. It is the line passing through center of curvature C and pole of the mirror. That is called principal axis. Third one, center of curvature. Center of curvature is the center of the sphere in which mirror is a part. See, you can see that concave mirror, first one is concave, second one is convex. And in concave mirror, we are considering the reflecting surface only. But if we are drawing that, we'll get a sphere. And that have one center, the C. So the C is called center of curvature. Center of curvature means it is the center of the sphere in which mirror is a part. Fourth point, radius of curvature. The letter R is used, radius of curvature, capital R. The radius of the sphere of which reflecting surface of the spherical mirror forms a part. In this figure, first one is concave mirror. The distance from pole to center C, that distance is called the radius of the sphere, or we can say that PC represents the radius of the sphere. In convex mirror also, the distance from pole to center of curvature is the radius of the sphere, and that is called radius of curvature. Then fifth term, principal focus of a concave mirror. Principal focus of a concave mirror is represented by the letter capital F. Consider the first figure. This is concave mirror. Draw principal axis, a line passing through center of curvature C and pole. Note down the point P. Then consider some of the parallel rays are incident on this concave mirror. So all these light rays incident on this mirror, then reflection takes place. All these light rays reflect and all these reflected rays meet at one point. That point is called focus point of the concave mirror. So in case of a concave mirror, all the reflected rays meet at one point. That point is called the focus point of the concave mirror. Consider the second figure. This is convex mirror. So you know that convex mirror is a diverging mirror. Consider some of the parallel rays are incident on this convex mirror and then these light rays reflect. If we are extending all these reflected rays, it will appear to meet at the F. So this F is the focus point of the convex mirror. In case of a convex mirror, all the light reflected rays appear to meet at one point. This point is called the focus point of the convex mirror. Seventh term, focal length. Focal length is the distance from pole and principal focus of a mirror. So in this figure, we can say that the distance from focus to pole, that distance is called focal length of the mirror. And for the case of convex mirror is also the same one. The distance from pole to focus, that distance is called the focal length of the mirror. So this focal length is entirely different from principal focus F. Principal focus, the letter capital F is used, and focal length, small letter F is used. Then the last term, aperture of the mirror. The aperture of the mirror is the diameter of the reflective surface of a spherical mirror. In this figure, you can see the reflective surface of the concave mirror. So this AB line represents the diameter of the reflective surface. And this diameter of this reflective surface is called aperture of the mirror. Second one represents convex mirror. The diameter AB represents the aperture of the convex mirror. So aperture means the diameter of the reflective surface of a spherical mirror. Next topic is representation of images formed by spherical mirrors using ray diagram. Before that, we want to study about some rules. There are different rules for that. After studying all these rules, we can draw the ray diagrams. Rule number one, consider concave mirror, a ray parallel to the principal axis. After reflection, that reflected ray will pass through the point F. Same in case of convex mirror also, but the difference is convex is a diverging mirror. A ray incident parallel to this, after reflection, that reflected ray appears to meet at F. If you are extending that reflected ray, you can see that the reflected ray appears to meet at F. This is the first rule. So if any ray which is parallel to the principal axis, the reflected ray will pass through the point F in case of a concave mirror and appears to meet at the point F in case of a convex mirror. Rule number two, a ray passing through the principal focus of a concave mirror or a ray which is directed towards the principal focus of a convex mirror after reflection will emerge parallel to the principal axis. That means a ray which is passes through focus, after reflection the reflected ray will be parallel to the principal axis. In case of a convex mirror, a ray incident on this convex mirror like this, if you are extending that incident ray passes through the point F. Actually, it is not passing through this F. If we are extending that, we can draw that line. So that reflected ray will be parallel with the principal axis. And this is rule number 2. Rule number 3. A ray passing through the center of curvature of a concave mirror or directed in the direction of the center of curvature of a convex mirror after reflection is reflected back along the same path. That means, look at the picture. You can see that in case of a convex mirror, a ray incident on this convex mirror, then after reflection, the ray will be reflected back along its same line. If you are extending that incident ray, that will pass through the point center of curvature. This is rule number 3. Next one, rule number 4. A ray incident obliquely to the principal axis towards the pole P on the concave mirror or a convex mirror is reflected obliquely following the laws of reflection at the point of incidence. That means you can see that here the angle of incidence, angle of reflection, and this angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. Next topic, image formation by concave mirror. This image formation by concave mirror or a convex mirror, which is very, very important topic. First one, there are different cases we are discussing with one by one. First case, object is at infinity. For that, consider concave mirror. For drawing this figure, first of all, we want to draw the reflecting surface of a concave mirror. Draw principal axis. Note down the point C, center of curvature, pole P, then the center of C and P, that is focus point F. Consider some of the parallel rays. These parallel rays are coming from infinity because here the object is at infinity. So the ray of light incident on this concave mirror, the first ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis. So what happened to that ray? We have studied the first rule. That ray will pass through the point F. Then consider another ray of light that is also parallel to the principal axis. So this ray also will pass through the point F. Then consider these two reflected rays. You can see that both these reflected rays meet at one point. Where is the meeting point? At F. Image is formed at F. That means if you are keeping object at infinity, in case of a concave mirror, the image will be formed at F. Then what will be the nature of the image? Yes, this is real and inverted image. Then what about the size? You can see that the size is very small, right? We can say that the image is diminished, right? Then next one, nature of the image. Nature of the image is real and inverted. And size of the image is diminished. Then position of the image is at F. This is the case when object is at infinity. Second case, when the object is beyond the center of curvature. BA represents position of the object. It is beyond C. So from the point A, one of the parallel ray incident on the concave mirror, and that ray will reflect and which passes through the point F. Then another ray which passes through center of curvature, and you know that if any ray which passes through center of curvature, it reflects back along its same line. Where is the meeting point? For getting image, we want to concentrate two reflected rays. So these two reflected rays meet at one point, and that point is A dash. From that point A dash, draw a perpendicular line to the principal axis. That means A dash B dash represents the image. So where is the position of the image? If you are keeping object beyond C, the position of the image is between C and F. Then what is the nature of the image? The image is real and inverted. The size of the image is small. From the figure itself, you can say that because this is the size. If you are considering the image size, the size of the image is less. Third case, when the object is at C, consider concave mirror, principal focus, center of curvature C and pole P. So the position of the object is at C. So from the point A, a parallel ray is incident on this concave mirror and that ray passes through the point focus. Then another ray of light passes through the point focus and that reflected ray will be parallel to the principal axis. For getting image, we have to consider these two reflected rays. So the meeting point is at C. So where is the position of the image? At A dash. So this A dash, B dash represents image. If we are keeping object at C, the position of the image is also at the same place. The position of the image is also at C. And the size, same size. The image size and object size remain same. The nature of the image is real and inverted. Position of the image is at C. Case 4. When the object lies between center of curvature and focus, draw concave mirror, principal focus, center of curvature and pole P. The position of the object is in between center of curvature and focus. So BA represents position of the object. From the point A, a ray of light incident on this concave mirror, that ray will pass through the point focus. Then another ray of light which is incident and that ray will pass through the point C. If we are extending both the reflected rays, it will be meet at the point A dash. So this A dash, B dash represents the image. So if we are comparing the size of the object and size of the image, you can see that this image is enlarged. If we are keeping the object in between center of curvature and focus, the size of the image is enlarged. The nature of the image is real and inverted. Position of the image is beyond C. Then fifth case, when the object is at the focus, for getting that image, draw concave mirror, principal axis, note down center of curvature C, focus point F and pole P. The position of the object is at F. So this AB represents position of the object. Then from the point A, a ray of light incident on the concave mirror and that ray is parallel to the principal axis. So that reflected ray will pass through the point focus F. Then another ray of light incident, that reflected ray will pass through the point C. Look at the picture. You can see that consider these two reflected rays. Both these reflected rays will be meet at infinity. We can say that both these reflected rays will be meet at infinity. That means the image will be formed at infinity. So in this case, if you are keeping object is at the focus, the image will be formed at infinity. And the size of the image is enlarged. Then the nature of the image is real and inverted. Last case, concave mirrors, last case, the position of the object is held between focus and pole. And this is the case of virtual image. In this case, we will get the virtual image. So, for getting virtual image, we want to keep the object in between focus point and pole. For drawing this one, consider concave mirror, draw concave mirror, draw principal axis, note on the point C, F and P. Then keep the object in between F and P. From the point A ray of light incident obliquely to the principal axis of a mirror. Then second ray of light which is incident on this concave mirror reflects back, which passes through the point C. For getting image, extend this two reflected rays. We can see that both these reflected rays will be meet at point A dash. From that point, draw perpendicular line to the principal axis. So this A dash B dash represents image, and this image is, that image is virtual and erect image. The size of the image is enlarged. Position of the image is behind the mirror. This is virtual and erect image. So the position of the image is behind the mirror. What are the uses of concave mirror? Look at the picture. You can see that it is used as a shaving mirror or makeup mirror. Then it is used by dentists to see the enlarged image of the teeth. Then third one, concave mirror is used in headlights of a car. These are the uses of concave mirror. Next topic, image formation by convex mirror. You know, convex mirror is a diverging mirror. So what type of image is formed? Virtual and erect images form, right? So let's see that image formation by a convex mirror. Case 1, when the object is held between infinity and pole of the mirror. For drawing this one, consider the reflecting surface of the convex mirror. Draw principal axis, note down the point P, pole, then focus point F, center of curvature C. The position of the object is held between infinity and pole. So this is the position of the object. From the point A ray of light incident on this convex mirror. The first ray which is parallel to the principal axis. So that ray reflects back. If we are extending that reflected ray, which will pass through the point F. Consider second ray of light. The second ray of light incident on this convex mirror, that will reflect back along its same line, because if you are extending that incident ray, it will pass through the point C. So we can say that the image will be formed in between pole and F, because both these reflected rays meet at A dash. This A dash B dash represents image, and where is the image formed? It is behind the mirror, because this image is virtual and erect image. The position of the image is in between P and F. One more case is there. Second case, when the object is at infinity. For drawing that, consider convex mirror. Draw principal axis. Note down the point P, F and C. Some of the parallel rays are incident on this convex mirror. So that both reflected rays will appear to meet at the point F. If any ray which is parallel to the principal axis, that ray will reflect back. If we are extending that reflected ray, that ray will pass through the point F. So you can see that both these reflected rays meet at the point F. Where is the position of the image? The position of the image is at F. Can you say what about the size of the image? Yes, the size of the image is very small. The nature of the image is virtual and erect image. What are the uses of convex mirror? Yes, you know that. The rear view mirror, convex mirror is used as a rear view mirror of vehicles. Convex mirrors give erect diminished images of objects. They also have a wider field of view than plane mirrors. That is why convex mirrors are used as rear view mirrors in vehicles. Next topic, new Cartesian sign convention for spherical mirrors. There are different rules. The first rule is all distances measured to the right of the pole are taken as positive. Here you can see concave mirror and convex mirror. The right of the things, for the case of convex mirror, you can see that the focus point and the center of curvature, which is at the right of the mirror, the things in the right side taken as positive. Here the focal length and the radius of curvature, which is positive for the case of a convex mirror. But in concave mirror, the center of curvature C, the radius of curvature R, focal length F, everything in the left side. So the things in the left side taken as negative. So here C is negative, F is negative and R is also negative. This is the first rule. Third rule, the height measured upwards perpendicular to the principal axis is taken as positive. That means here you can see the position of the object. We are keeping object always in the left side of the mirror. So if you are keeping the object this like upward direction, then the height of that object considered as positive. Then suppose sometimes we'll get inverted image. That inverted image is this like. The downward height represents negative. We can conclude all distances measured to the right of the pole are taken as positive. Second rule, all distances measured to the left of the pole are taken as negative. Third rule, the height measured upwards perpendicular to the principal axis is taken as positive. Last one, the height measured downwards perpendicular to the principal axis is taken as negative. Next topic, mirror formula for spherical mirrors. Mirror formula means it is a relation between object distance U, image distance V and focal length F. The relation is 1 by U plus 1 by V equals 1 by F, where U is the object distance, V is the image distance and F is the focal length. The mirror formula is 1 by U plus 1 by V equals 1 by F. Magnification for spherical mirrors. Magnification for spherical mirrors is the ratio of height of the image to the height of the object. Means M is equal to H dash divided by H, where H dash is the height of the image and H is the height of the object. So magnification M is equal to H dash by H. One more equation is there. In terms of object distance and image distance, we can write one more equation, M is equal to minus V by U, where V is the image distance and U be the object distance. Today's section we have discussed about the reflection of spherical mirrors. That's all. Thank you.